Holy shit. Well, thank you, everybody. I usually, when I do hosting stuff, I have to say I'm Eddie Trunk, but I think you guys know that, right? So, I don't even know where to begin, because for the last week or two, my head has been like just on a swivel. But this is, in a word, surreal for me. Just walking backstage right now to come out here, I literally walked through the history of heavy rock music back there right now. And there's something really important that all of you guys need to know. Nobody coming out on this stage tonight and performing is being paid to do it. Not a penny. They're doing it because they wanted to be here for me for this event. They wanted to celebrate rock and roll, and they wanted to celebrate this evening. And that means so much to me, I can't even begin to tell you. And you are all here for that same reason, right? And I also want you to know this, because when I did this, I said, I only want people to be there that want to be there. I am not making a penny from this. Tonight, all the proceeds are going to the Dio Cancer Fund. And somewhere out there, my friend Wendy Dio is in the house. I don't know where you are, Wendy. Wherever she is, but Wendy, where is she? Is she up? Wendy, you should be up here saying a few words. Do we have time for Wendy to come up here? Come up, Wendy, hurry up. My dear friend Wendy is gonna make her way up here, because I've hosted all of the charity events for the Dio Cancer Fund since they've happened, and it's been an honor to do so, and it's such an amazing charity. And can we get a round of applause for the late, great Ronnie James Dio, who is always with us. And I'm sure you've seen the phenomenal new documentary. But when we figure this all out at the end of the event, whatever money is left, and there's going to be a lot because you fuckers sold this thing out in seconds, we are going to give every penny of that to the Dio Cancer Fund. So thank you all. But I gotta tell you guys, I never ever thought I'd be doing this for 40 years. There's been a lot of people that have come up to me and they say, happy birthday. It's not my birthday. I wish I was 40. My birthday's in August. Tonight we're celebrating 40 years of me yapping on the radio, which started back in New Jersey in 1983. Ladies and gentlemen, Wendy Dio.
Honored to be here. This man has done 40 years of keeping metal and rock and roll alive. We couldn't have done it without him. He does so much for my cancer fund. He's always there to support. And thank you all for coming, because we know that we're going to celebrate Eddie tonight.
Thank you, Wendy. Appreciate it very much. So, and also, speaking of charity, is my friend Chris Angel in the house yet? Is Chris here yet? Because if he may just appear, because he is a magician. He can just appear and disappear. He may just descend from the rafters or something. But Chris, I know I wanted him to come up and say a few words if he could, because he's doing a phenomenal charity as well that he does for pediatric cancer. And he's got a big fundraising event coming up, but I'm not sure if he's here just yet. But anyway, listen, you guys, I'm gonna pop out from time to time when I can. These guys are giving me shots backstage, so I might not be standing by halfway through the show. But I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna tell you this. We have an extremely long evening of music for you. Now, I know we're a bit older here, but you're up for a late night of music, right? We do have a curfew, but I can guarantee at least 3 hours. And I can also tell you that the only artists we announced, of course, were Sammy Hagar and Michael Anthony. And my amazing musical directors, Brent Woods and Mike Portnoy. However, When I tell you, your mind is going to be blown about who is going to jam out here tonight. You're not going to believe it. You are not going to believe who's backstage and who's going to play. I am so honored. I am so humbled. I am so grateful. I want to thank all of you for being here. I want to thank my family for being here. My kids, my parents. Ray, Elizabeth, Jen, my mom and dad, Ray and Rose. Mom, dad, come out and wave to the crowd. Come on out here. You guys all want to come out? Come out. Say hello. This is, my mom is freaked out. She just met, well, I can't, should I say who's backstage? I don't know. My mom just met a singer she really likes. We'll leave it at that. She's all excited. But anyway, you guys, I couldn't do 40 years of radio without all of your support. I want to thank everybody that I've worked with in the past, the promoters, the program directors, the radio stations. I want to thank everybody at MGM, everybody at Live Nation, Paul McQuiggan here at the House of Blues, my friend Paul Davis at MGM. There are so many people I need to thank, and I'll try to do that throughout the course of the night. And it's just overwhelming, it really is. But thank you for supporting what I do for 40 years, whether you jumped in a week ago or 40 years ago. It means the world to me. And I really shouldn't say this because my parents are here, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Are you fucking ready to rock? Because at the end of the day, that's what it's about. One picture with all of you, then we're gonna get the music started. Let's see you. All right, so I'm just looking at this set list is insane. Okay, so if we're gonna start a night of music celebrating the music I've loved, which is heavy rock, hard rock, metal, whatever you wanna call it, I am beyond honored to have to kick things off what I call the founding fathers of heavy rock. You know who that is, right? It's only one answer to that. That's Black Sabbath. And I am incredibly grateful and honored to call among my friends the one and only Black Sabbath bassist and lyricist, Geezer Butler. And singing some classic Sabbath with Geezer Butler, one of my favorite singers on the planet, Jay Buchanan from Rival Sons. And one of my favorite singers on the planet from Slipknot, Corey Taylor. So let's get this shit started. Are you ready? Let's get it going with a little Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath.
Yeah. Let's just get this out of the way real quick. Is everybody ready for the wizard? Tonight, or ever, if it wasn't for Mr. Eddie Trunk. Please welcome my bandmates, Mr. Billy Sheehan on bass. Yeah. And Mr. Richie Thompson on guitar and vocals. Uh-huh.
real that this is actually happening for this event. I just invited people. I didn't make offers. I didn't offer money. Nobody got paid, nothing. And this is a guy that is one of my favorite people in the world. And needless to say, another one of those people that is an architect of the music we love. And if you are into theatrical rock music, the guy coming out here is the man who started it, ladies and gentlemen. In the 60s. You kind of figuring it out who might be coming out here right now? I gotta tell you, I sent a note and I got a response back that said, Eddie, he would love to do it. And it just blew my head out because he is an icon, he is a legend, he is a Rock and Roll Hall of Famer. And joining him, on the stage to perform with him, my friend Mr. Tyson Leslie up here on keyboards. Eventually, Glenn Sobel will be out here to play drums. Brent Woods is on guitar. Brent, come here, brother. Come here. Real quick, while we got a little time here, I gotta tell you, this guy means the world to me right here. He is a brother. I love him to death. And he just kicked ass for me to make this thing happen. So thank you, Brent. The best right here. And over here on the bass guitar, Mr. Robbie Crane is here once again. And making the stage far more beautiful right now, ladies and gentlemen, also coming out on guitar is Orianti. Give her a round of applause. And in the next song, coming out, I think... Okay, so throughout the course of this set, Mr. Kip Winger is going to be out here for a little bit. There's Kip. Say hello, you handsome bastard, because I think you're going to come out. Here he is. Oh, yeah, Eddie Trunk. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you may have figured this out, who's coming out. But again, this is in that moment of being completely surreal that this is happening for my party. Ladies and gentlemen, I just can't speak more highly about the icon who is about to walk out on this stage. All I can say is one word, Alice. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Alice Cooper.
Such a sweet, sweet thing to be. represent car shows now. He's got some badass rides though, I gotta tell you that.
All right, if you don't know this song, there's something wrong with you, okay? This is a sing-along, and I expect you to sing along, all right?
Choice of you girls and boys.
before he comes out on stage. So if he gets his set out of the way, then he can really start working the blender a little bit, you know? But let me tell you a quick story while I have a second here. This, when I was a kid, long before I was in radio, I loved Sammy Hagar. And I'm from New Jersey, and Sammy will be the first to tell you that he never did all that well on the East Coast. So I used to have to drive a little bit to go see him once I got my license. And this is the God's honest truth. I used to watch Sammy Hagar on stage at places like the Spectrum in Philadelphia. And some of these other places I would drive because I had to go see him. And I would look at him and I'd be like, you know, that guy's different. He's one of us. He's a regular dude. He's having fun up there. He's not strutting around big time, acting bigger and more important than everybody else. He's the real deal. And I swear to God, I used to go tell my parents and my friends, you know, if I ever met that guy, I could become friends with him. The true story, when I was like 15, 16, 17 years old, if you find my high school yearbook, I was doing music reviews and I was reviewing records like Standing Hampton and Three Lock Box and VOA. And lo and behold, not too long after all that, I got into the music industry and son of a bitch, we became great friends. And let me tell you this, and this is the truth. This night does not happen without Sammy Hagar. And here's what I mean by that. Because he and I were talking, and we were talking about how long we knew each other or something. And I said to Sammy, I go, well, you know, I've been doing this 40 years, and I've been thinking about, and before I could finish the sentence, he said to me, what do you need? And I said, what do I need? I go, well, I've been thinking about doing an event. And he goes, what do you need? I'm in. And I said, you'll let me use your name to promote it? He said, yep. I'll play some songs, whatever you need. And that's all Sammy Hagar said to me. No bullshit, no demands, no rock star nonsense. So that guy that I saw on stage at 15, 16, what I thought about him was the truth, because he is the real deal and is one of the greatest people you could ever meet. And it's no coincidence that his partner in crime, Mr. Michael Anthony, is the same coolest guy you could ever friggin' meet. And here he is right now. And I love this guy to death. And he's the best right here as well. Michael Anthony, ladies and gentlemen.
How you guys doing tonight?
And when I talked to Sammy about it, I said, can we get Michael? And he said, oh yeah, Mikey's in. And I said, fuck yeah. Now Michael is gonna stick around and play some old school Van Halen in a little bit. But to come out and play a little something from his catalog, and you know these guys are getting ready to go out on tour together with Joe Satriani and Jason Bonham next summer. It's gonna be incredible. But ladies and gentlemen, again, this man is just the best and just a freak of nature, the freak of freaks like Alice Cooper. Next up, the Red Rocker! The one, the only, the undisputed rock and roll champ! And of course he's got a cocktail in his hand! Sammy Hagar! Let's go, let's hear it, come on!
Well, how can I follow that? Mikey, can we live up to that shit you just said? Well, here's the first song I ever wrote in my life. Figure might as well start in the beginning. First song I wrote in my life, a little band called Mantra. When you get alone, you're down.
We got Mike Portnoy coming back on drums up here. We got a little change out on the drums. We got Brent still out here on guitar. Mike, anything you want to say to the audience before we proceed?
Yeah, Eddie, go get a fucking drink, will you?
I got him over here on the
sit
side.
Sit back and enjoy the show.
That's what I do. Give it up.
Okay, we're going to give you a little bit of old DH for you, right? Got my new buddy, Mike Portnoy. I just met Mike last night. Incredible fucking drummer, right? And he's gonna show me what to do here. We're not. Guitar change. Why does this happen when I come up? I don't know any fucking stand up or any of that shit. You guys having a good time tonight, though?
Yeah.
Come on, how about fucking Eddie Trunk? This guy, I was on his metal show for a couple of times. This fucker knows more of the history of Van Halen than I even knew. You know, he was telling me what the. I didn't know that, Ed. Shit. But anyway, while we're waiting for a guitar player, Mike, should we do this with bass and drums? Yeah.
Awesome teacher!
Now, see, if you would have told me that, we might have played that one tonight. Brent!
Oh,
another old one? Brent, I think Brent, you're gonna start this out. Oh, wait, we got my buddy Richie Conson up here. Well, shit, let's fucking jam, huh?
Yes, I do.
Oh, goddamn. You know what? I live here in Vegas now, too. I got a house here in Vegas.
Can I tell you guys something?
What?
Around the time where Gary Cherone joined Van Halen, Doc McGee did have a meeting with me about joining Van Halen. But Van Halen was concerned because But the thing is, I learned to smoke pot because of Van Halen. So what the fuck? Anyways, it all worked out. It all worked out.
After all these years, Skid Row and Van Halen played together. God. Hey, Sebastian, hey. Hey, fucker, come over here. Wait, wait. I was gonna give Eddie Trunk a hug.
Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, hold on.
You need to get the balance tour. We did the balance tour a couple weeks.
That's right, and we've never played on stage together. Well, let's fucking do it.
Let's rock it.
Wait, you guys need a guitar player, and I got one for you. Coming out on this song right now, formerly of Five Finger Death Punch, currently with a great band called Flash Black. Give it up for Jason Hall.
Let's rock out!
A diamond record is a record that sold over 10 million copies, and he has that with a record called High Infidelity, which I'm sure every one of you guys must own. If it sold over 10 million, you all must have it, right? One of my all-time favorite songs is on there called Taken on the Run. I think he's gonna do that tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor, privilege to welcome to the stage right now the front man from REO Speedwagon, Mr. Kevin Cronin. Give it up, give him some love.
Has single-handedly kept rock and roll alive in the ears of the people of America. Let's hear for Eddie. Come on. Oh, shit. You know, normally I play acoustic guitar. We're rocking tonight, man. Get that shit out of here. All right.
Every weekend, they're talking about kids, burning the guy. my God, all my old friends are here. So, you know, it is a party backstage, Eddie. Keyboards.
because he is the real deal. We have carved up some bar stools together with a chainsaw. I'll leave it at that. Ladies and gentlemen, from Jackal, Mr. Jesse James Dupree. Kiss Destroyer, and it changed my life, and it's probably why I do what I do and have done what I've done for the last 40 years. And this man that's about to come out has been a friend to me since 1987 when we first met, and I actually signed him to his first ever solo record deal after Kiss when I was working for a label. And to this day, we've remained great friends. And he flew out here from New Jersey, where he now lives, just to be here and play for me and you tonight. He has a brand new single that's just come out called 10,000 Volts. He's got a new record coming out next year, and he is the one and only Space Ace Frehley. Get ready to come out here and kick some ass. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the legend, the icon, the Rock and Roll Hall of Famer, a founding member of KISS, Ace fucking Frehley!
You know, Ed Trunk was responsible for getting me my first record deal because nobody wanted to sign me, and he's been with me ever since, helping me make a living and backing me when shit was down. But I'm so happy to be here for his 40th anniversary in radio. God bless Eddie. And I guess you guys want to hear a song, right? First solo record, it's called Rip It Out. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Bye. up, all right? Where's Tom? You work with people you never worked before. Next thing you know, they promise you the world and you get shit. Okay, this one I wrote about a groupie back in the 70s. It's called Parasites.
And we have to be done at 11:30, so what do you say we squeeze in 15 more minutes? You guys up for that, right? I think so. Because I gotta tell you, this is one of the greatest nights of my life. I don't know about you. This is like rock and roll history going on this stage, and I am so honored and so grateful for all of you for coming out and for all of these amazing artists for coming out and playing for us tonight. It's simply surreal, so thank you all. All right, so when I started in radio back in 83, which is what we're celebrating, there was a band that I saw at an amusement park in New Jersey, where I'm from, that was called Great Adventure, and they were playing on their first album, an album called Dawn Patrol, and I remember hearing a song called Don't Tell Me You Love Me, and it totally blew my mind. I was just out of high school, and here was this great dual guitar band with this little guy bouncing around playing bass and singing lead vocals. And that band, of course, was Night Ranger. Now, let me tell you guys real quickly. Jack Blades of Night Ranger and Kelly Kagi totally planned to be here tonight, but they weren't feeling well and they were not able to travel, so they couldn't make it. But from Night Ranger, the king of the whammy bar and a good friend and a phenomenal guitar player who also, of course, played with Ozzy on the Speak of the Devil album. Give it up for Mr. Brad Gillis over here, ladies and gentlemen. Love this guy and love his playing and always did. And he's gonna do a Night Ranger classic for you. And if we have time, we're gonna end with one last jam before we call it. We got Zach Throne over here on guitar. And now we can afford David Ellison. You know David from Megadeth. David Ellison, ladies and gentlemen, on the bass. From Warrants, my old friend Robert Mason is gonna sing for you. And Glenn Sobel back here killing it on the drums. So, we got some time left. We're gonna let Brad do his thing. Are you ready for some Night Ranger? Let's do it. Don't Tell Me You Love Me, rockin'. We'll be right back.
Tired yet?
Freddy!
Here you go.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, give Bradley a second. You're right out there, I worry when you're so damn quiet. Why are you so quiet?
Mr. Brad Gillis.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we hear it from Mr. Brad Gillis, Robert Mason, Zach Throne, Glenn Sobel, David Ellison. So Tyson Leslie with the coolest pants in the venue. Look at those pants Tyson's wearing back there on the keyboards, right out of 1988. So according to the clock, it's 11:27 and we gotta stop. Unless somebody's got 15 grand that they want to put into the overtime. Chuck, you already spent money. What? Hold on a minute.
All-star jazz.
Yeah, we're done. That was 3.5 hours of music. Come on now. Yeah, we got to call it. So I wouldn't even know where to begin. But this was a night that I will never forget, and I want to thank every single musician who was on this stage tonight. And I want to thank my friend Mike Portnoy, who's back here. Mike, come on out, take a quick bow, sit. Mike, come on out, brother. Give it up for Mike. Brent Woods, come out here, man. Ace Frehley. Whoever's in the wings of the stage, just come out and take a bow, man. Everybody, Chuck, get out of here. Everybody, come on out. Whoever wants to come out who's in the wings of the stage, come take a bow. We got 2 minutes before we got to get out of here. Hal Sparks is here. Hal, come take a bow. Everybody. This was an amazing team effort. Brent and Scotty Ludwig, Doug Burgess, Portnoy, everybody who helped coordinate this. And, you know, there's so many people I couldn't begin to thank. Thank you, everybody, I appreciate it so much from the bottom of my heart. I hope I'm still standing in a few more years and keep doing this for a little bit longer, if you'll have me. Thank you to SiriusXM for giving me a home. Thank you to all of the producers, program directors, promoters, everybody I've worked with in my career. It means the world to me. And most of all, thank you to each and every one of you for being here tonight, listening, supporting. Trunk Nation fans, thank you. You're the best. Rock and roll is alive and well, and we showed that tonight on stage. Get home safe. Ace just told me he saw Paul Stanley's avatar. You want to say anything about that, Ace?
No, he's gonna plead the fifth.
That's what he said in my ear, just in case you were wondering. We need an Ace Frehley avatar, don't we? We don't need it. We don't need an avatar. We got the real guy right here, still kicking ass. Still kicking ass. But whoever is not up here, wherever you went, thank you, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I don't even know where to begin or where to stop, but I gotta stop. So thank you all. In the words of Ozzy, I love you all. Thank you for coming. We'll see you out there in the bar, in the casino. We'll keep it rocking. Be well, everybody. Happy, healthy 2024. Thank you so much for an incredible, legendary night. Thank you. Get home safe.